What's up, YouTube? I am Leo with Mining Sumo, and I just went to Micro Center and scored three of these. Well, I actually could buy more, but I bought three of these B250 FinTech motherboards. So these are 12 GPU motherboards, and they cost only $150. And so right now Micro Center has a pretty good stock on them. Our Micro Center in Cambridge, Mass, or in Boston, had 15. I bought three, so now they're down to 12. And why I bought this one? Because B250 Mining Expert by Asus now goes for $300. They just jacked up the price, just doubled it. Just crazy. They also jacked up prices on power supplies, and their GPU prices are completely crazy. So if you're a gamer, if you're a miner, Micro Center for the time being, for now, is not the place to buy GPUs anymore. So what's great about this motherboard? Like I said, it's a 12 GPU motherboard. I'll show it to you real quick. Just a simple So right there, 12 GPUs on it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, yeah, so like 10 here, 11, 12 basically. And you have one power supply adapter port here, 24 pin, but you also get this guy, so you can do two power supplies with it. And you also got this thing. I'm not sure what this is yet. There's two buttons on it. I think it's something like a power button for the second GPU, for the second power supply. I'm gonna figure it out later. But yeah, basically 12 GPU motherboard, only $150. And now if you don't have Micro Center near you, they are on Amazon for $185, so a little not as good of a deal. But you know, with B250s and everything else costing near $300, I'm talking about mining motherboards, I think this is a very sweet deal. So if you have a Micro Center near you, go grab one if you need it. And if you don't have a Micro Center, I'll put a link to the Amazon listing for this motherboard. And if you buy it with our link, support the channel, we get a little commission, you don't pay anything extra. So like I said, three of them. There's one more and two more right there. So yeah, pretty good deal, guys. About the GPUs, so right now they jacked up prices on their GPUs again, and it's completely crazy, completely like ridiculous. And we all feel the pain. The good news is the GPU prices started to go down on Amazon and on Newegg. They're not at a good level yet, but they're getting there. And if you want to buy a lot of GPUs, there are two sources online that I know of. There's malabs.com and ASI Solutions or something like that. Basically ASI computer parts. Just search for that on Google. I think you do need to have some kind of a corporate account with them to buy it. But basically the prices they publish online are higher than what they actually charge. I've signed up with MA Labs, and then their inside or outside sales guy emailed me saying their actual prices are lower than what they charge, you know, than what they list on the website. And then they don't list many prices. Most of the parts on MA Labs, at least, they are unlisted as far as pricing. But there are still sources to get GPUs for good, you know, close to MSRP. So check them out. And like I said, this 12 GPU motherboard, Micro Center still has them in stock, so go grab them if you want. I grabbed three. Now I need GPUs for this because I don't have enough GPUs anymore. But it's a very good price. And just so you know, the B250 Mining Expert, first of all, they jacked up the price to $300, so it's completely like makes no sense to buy it anymore. I have one on order for $157. That's gonna come in about a week, hopefully. I have a few GPUs, not enough, on order. Three more 1060s. But basically, you can As far as I understand, you can only put 13 GPUs on the B250 Mining Expert unless you have the mining GPUs, the P106 mining GPUs, and only then you can go up to 19, but you need like 7 or 8 of those P106, you know, NVIDIA mining GPUs. They're pretty good, as far as like, they're pretty cool, they do give good hash rate, but it's impossible to find, they're expensive, and, you know, everything is expensive, so you can't really get more than 13 in the Mining Expert unless you have the P106s, so, you know, 19 GPU is a gimmick for the most part, therefore, 12, 13, not a big deal, and this is a very good choice. I'm gonna do a setup with this motherboard, and I'm gonna let you know how it runs. I'll do a full review, so stay tuned. If you enjoyed this video, please strike that like button. Please subscribe to the channel. I very much appreciate all the new subscriptions once I start publishing the mining videos. Now, I did make a video about my trip to Micro Center, and there is a lot of unhappy gamers commenting on it. And guys, I used to be a gamer. I understand your pain, but you know, it's not my fault that GPU prices are up, and I don't even think it's the miner's fault. If you watched, there was a video by Gamers something, like they explained why there is a shortage of GPUs. Now, I completely disagree with the notion. Basically what they said is GPU shortages are not caused by AMD and NVIDIA, they are caused by manufacturers of the actual graphics card. True. Now, AMD and NVIDIA can produce more actual, you know, GPU chips, graphics chips. And manufacturers of the graphics cards do not order enough because they're afraid that the mining bubble will pop and they're gonna be stuck with a lot of, you know, unsold GPUs, especially since new generation should come sometimes this year. Well, here are my thoughts on it. They don't have to double the production, you know, like, let's say they're making 100,000 GPUs per month, and they know there is a huge demand, you know, make 110,000, make 120, it's marginal, you don't have to double the production, you can increase it marginally by like 10, 15, 20%, and at these rates, the miners will buy them up, because it is still very much profitable to mine. Now, when I started mining Ethereum, it was $690, and now it's like over $800, so it's still very much profitable. Yes, the difficulty went up, but still we're all making money. The bubble did not pop, the crypto prices went up. Now, they might go down, but I don't think, I'll actually make a separate video on why I mine Ethereum exclusively. Well, not exclusively anymore. I actually switched all my NVIDIA GPUs to Z Classic just to before the Bitcoin private is released, so I can get a few Z Classics, and then I will, when they hard fork Bitcoin private, then I will get a few of those coins, and then I'll switch back to Ethereum for the most part. But yeah, I'll make a video why I'm only mining Ethereum. I think it's a very good topic to discuss. So, a lot of things to talk about. Like I said, I'll make a review of this motherboard, I'll slap a lot of GPUs on it. Most of them will be low-end, but so stay tuned for that, and for my Ethereum mining video. So, thank you again, please subscribe, like this video, let me know what you think about it in the comments, if you have this motherboard, and if you, you know, have some suggestions on how to make it work better, you know, let me know. If you hated my video about Micro Center and GPU shortages, let me know why, guys. I mean, there is a lot of dislikes, that's the only video with like huge amount of dislikes, but and I understand your pain, but I think it's mostly the fault of manufacturers of the GPUs that we actually have a shortage. They could increase the supply marginally, they knew that miners are buying stuff up, you know, they could have done it 2-3 months ago, they didn't. In any case, thanks for watching. Again, I'm Leo with Mining Summa, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.